Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. Today I will talk about access strategies in JPA and Hibernate and explain if you should use field or property access. But before we start, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. The access strategy defines how your JPA implementation, for example Hibernate or EclipseLink, access your entity attributes. You can choose between field-based access and property-based access. If you use field-based access, your JPA implementation uses reflection to read or write your entity attributes directly. It also expects that you place your mapping annotations on your entity attributes. If you use property-based access, you need to annotate the getter methods of your entity attributes with the required mapping annotations. Your JPA implementation then calls the getter and setter methods to access your entity attribute. That might sound like a minor internal difference, but as I will show you in this video, the access strategy has a noticeable impact on your entity implementation and can also affect your business code. So the question is, which one should you prefer? But before we dive into the differences between the two, let me quickly explain how to configure an access strategy. By default, you specify the access strategy implicitly by annotating your primary key attribute or its getter method with an ID annotation. If you annotate the attribute itself, Hibernate uses field-based access. And if you annotate a getter method with the ID annotation, Hibernate uses property-based access to set and read the attributes of this entity. If you want to mix both access strategies within one entity or a hierarchy of entities, you need to override the default strategy with an access annotation. Otherwise, the JPA specification defines the behavior as undefined. Here you can see an example in which I used the access annotation to change the access strategy of the version attribute from property-based to field-based access. As explained earlier, you most often specify your access strategy by annotating the attributes or getter methods of your entity. But which strategy should you use? Does it make a real difference? Yes, it does make a difference. I always recommend using field-based access. Here are 5 reasons why field-based access is the better access strategy. Reason 1. Better readability of your code. Writing readable code is important. You should always consider how a specific implementation visually affects your code. And because the access strategy defines where you can place your mapping annotations, it has a significant impact on readability. If you use field-based access, you annotate your entity attributes with your mapping annotations. By placing the definition of all entity attributes at the top of your class, you get a relatively compact view of all attributes and their mappings. You can't achieve that with property-based access because the implementation of your getter methods spreads over multiple lines. This requires you to scroll through more code, and this makes it much harder to get an overview of an entity and its mapping. Reason 2. Omit getter or setter methods that shouldn't be called by your application. If you use field-based access, your persistence provider doesn't use the getter and setter methods of your entity attributes. That means that you don't need to provide any method that shouldn't be used by your business code. This is most often the case for setter methods of generated primary key attributes or version columns. Your persistence provider manages the values of these attributes, and you should not set them programmatically. You can also provide utility methods that enable you to add or remove elements from a too-many association and prevent direct access to the underlying list or set. This makes the implementation of your business code more comfortable and is a general best practice for bidirectional many-to-many associations. As you can see, field-based access gives you the flexibility to implement only the getter and setter methods that should be used by your business code. That makes your entities much easier to use and helps you to prevent bugs. Reason 3. Flexible implementation of getter and setter methods. Because your persistence provider doesn't call the getter and setter methods, they are not forced to fulfill any external requirements. You can implement these methods in any way you want. That enables you to implement business-specific validation rules to trigger additional business logic or to convert the entity attribute into a different data type. I used that in the following example to wrap an optional association in a Java optional. Even so, JPA and Hibernate don't support optional as an attribute type, field-based access enables you to use it as the return type of a getter method. Reason 4. No need to mark utility methods as transient. The transient annotation tells your persistence provider that a method or attribute is not part of the entity persistent state. And because with field type access, the persistent state gets defined by the attributes of your entity, your JPA implementation ignores all methods of your entity. Reason 5. Avoid bugs when working with proxies. Hibernate uses proxies for lazily fetch to run associations so that it can control the initialization of these attributes. That approach works fine in almost all situations, but it introduces a dangerous pitfall if you use property-based access. If you use property-based access, Hibernate initializes the attributes of the proxy object when you call the getter method. That's always the case if you use the proxy object in your business code. But quite a lot of equals and hashcode implementations access the attributes directly. If this is the first time you access any of the proxy attributes, these attributes are still uninitialized. You can easily avoid this pitfall by using the field-based access strategy. All JPA implementations, like Hibernate and EclipseLink, support two access strategies that define how your persistence provider reads and sets the attributes of your entity. The field-based access strategy uses reflection, and the property-based access strategy uses the getter and setter methods of your entity. This might seem like a slight internal difference, but as we have discussed in this video, the access strategy affects how you can implement your entity and might even help you to avoid bugs. That's why I always recommend using the field-based access strategy. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!